All right. Back at it.
Ooh, I'm sleeping today.
Human. Unlock. Move this up to where you can see it, I guess. Hi, Nick. Thank you for being on an 18-month streak, Nick. How's your day going? Ugh, I've been waiting for this. If anyone put Ugh in front of it, it almost seems like you weren't. Oh, good. Today, I'm exhausted. I wound up cleaning the entire house. The entire apartment. And it kind of got out of hand earlier. I lost track of time because I was like dusting everything and vacuuming everything and mopping everything. And unlike the Stockholm apartment, which was one room, this is actually got some space to it. So. Oh. Been sick lately. You, your wife, and kid find some good streaming. That's no good. Just sort of seasonal cold stuff. What's going on, Maze? Lagging? Am I? Let me check the bitrate. Seems okay. Hey, Zukin. Now I was slow to respond, but that's just because I was distracted. What kind of lag? What's it look like? Hey, Demon. Hello, Dantron. Hey, Fenner. Yeah, poor satellite bats. Belfaster, thank you. So we'll have a capsule crew day one day, maybe in the future, where we'll bring them all back and properly say goodbye. I meant to like set up a thing where we would maybe have a goodbye party for them. And I did not get that sent out this weekend, and we started getting stuff in, so maybe we'll bring them back for one last hurrah when the merch is available or something. Let's go look at some of these critters. We'll go look at them in a second. Make your GMs look like capsules. Give them some creepy data earth vibes. I'll give them the option of illusion capsule, maybe. I need to figure out what's going on with the Twitch music thing. I wish we could just play normal music. Some days like today, I just want to listen to normal music. Hey, Pattis. Good for now. Oh man, I rushed it. I jumped the gun. Oops. What was I learning? Cell shield? Okay. Hey, Shreddy. Man, today was a blur. A blur. These guys are scurrying along pretty quickly. May have to adjust move speed once we get stuff in. Oh, look at the bat gliding along though. Looked like it was gliding just now. Just change desert to ice and you don't need to animate them? Hmm, good point. But then we have to give them ice skate. Zukin? That guy's looking pretty. Looks even prettier in here than he did in the images. Hey, Homestead. No, 4, 6, 7. Hello. Oh, there's a snake. Snake. Who needs animations? Are you mainly focused on rigging and messing around with animations right now, Zukin, or? So Ali's got some thoughts on animations. And I can't remember. Did we just talk about that with him? I know for the player character, we're looking at a mix of, we want to mix in some procedural stuff to see if it can help us long-term. I'm also keyframing and trying to get, like, a specific look to it. So, like, specific energy and wind-up and key moments in the animation, but then do procedural blending, I guess. So, Belfaster. So Ollie's, I don't know, starting last year, he was sharing this really cool video of this procedural setup that that a guy's posted videos of on YouTube. It's really, really cool looking, the way it blends and handles all the different cases. Hey, Zookin. So it's, I think it's something that we've just really been wanting to play with. What's going on there? You just burned through your mana. Bunch of fizzles. Where the Hershey, when did the Hershey bats go away? This weekend. So we'll bring them back for a goodbye party at some point before it's all over with. But we're excited to get these in, so. But yeah, Belfast, we're definitely going to be playing around with that. I think starting early December, they're wrapping up work right now on a milestone. And then I think early mid-December, we'll be doing more animation work, unless I'm thinking of the roadmap out of order. What's going on with it? There's like a little, I'm noticing there's like a weird little lag that happens. And I haven't noticed that until tonight. Yeah, Cryptini. We'll put together a goodbye party for the capsules at some point. Maybe we'll wait until everything's replaced. Once everything's replaced, maybe we'll have a capsule party. That way we can maximize the amount of work we have to do in order to have the party. Bullet catcher? Thank you. Team's done fantastic on that front.
You guys got character animations?
Not yet. Not yet. They're gonna be coming. But thank you for the 15 months, Maze. Yeah, so have you guys been noticing, do you notice this little, there's like a little pause that's going on right now? Yeah. Oh, character animations, I think will be something, if I didn't say this in the earlier ramble about it, that's going to be one of those things we're going to iterate on a bunch. Like, character animations with the look that we're going for, my opinion, I don't know, I could be wrong, but I really think with the look that we're going for, if we can get really, really, really just solid, smooth, but fantastic. Again, that fantastic realism, not so super over the top, but something that sells that living in an illustration kind of thing. If we can get the animations wired, then we're going to be in a really great spot. Bone gloves. Cathedian. Hello. Alright. Let me go. Yeah, this hitching is going to bother me. Fieldfish, thank you for the follow. I never sat and debugged what's going on with my other monitor, but only does it when I'm streaming and using the editor. It blanks out for like a few seconds every once in a while. Any wrong, but hey. All right. Facial expressions, or would it just be, it's just static painted faces for now. had some weird ideas in the past. I was like, I wonder if we could animate these static faces or at least change the expressions and eyes and this and that. But it may look like complete shit and it's definitely not a priority, but... But painted faces for now. What you see in the update art is, I think it's well on its way to being the direction that we go for. Fizzle, 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 fizzle. Getting better at channeling. Don't worry, it's bugged. Thank you. Interaction with the gnome is very cool. You guys need to have a cyclops that runs away when someone says Odysseus. Sneak it in. Give the sirens something to say about them. Further reduce the fizzle rate. Okay. Nick is addressing the fizzles as we speak. I've got the top of my screen clipped a little bit. Sorry about that, but if I go to open the database, then it'll be better if that's the case. This thing does build character. Nick, I've literally never set my level or skills in here. Let me pick some different music. As much as I love these games, I'm really not enjoying the music at the moment. Okay. Maybe I'll just switch. No. Cryptini, probably a little bit later, though. It's been on my mind again lately. Just because I've been thinking about video, like getting, just because I really need to, oof, man, look at that list of skills, spoilers. I go real fast so you can't see it. No, hit it from you. So I need to get in and even if it's not great, I need to get in and cobble together a little preview video. So, or somebody needs to, but in lieu of somebody that will make a great one, I can also just make one. Farming. Oh, the crazy plans we have. Cotswold, you'll be amazed and amused. All right, pet. It's gonna be up to you. You know, Ollie is a farmer by trade. Let me know if that's too loud in your ear. I'm not quite sure how I'll turn it down, but... What am I doing? Oh, wait. We don't have that ability yet. All right. I felt so much like I was playing on P99 that I was immediately trying to just drag my pet attack down to the hot bar. Got back in EQ after a little stint. Noticed someone selling Ezreal's Ring of Analogies for 20 KR and Nazar on Mischief. That's cool. I feel like I've been off the analogy game for a while. I need to... All the talking I do, I don't really do that many analogies these days. But yeah, Brix, I am doing well. I hope you're doing well as well. I wonder how many more wells I can put in there. Doug, what's going on? How are you? Thank you for the follow. Not even allegories. I feel like I'm just kind of rambling these days. Oh man, that's fast. Omens is already out. Crazy. I actually didn't. I was able to not fizzle. Nice. Move this over here. Yeah, I'm not quite sure what that hitching is today. I sure can. Thank you, Doug. We should catch up at some point soon. Nick, did you need it while he's in combat or just in general? Oh, my gosh. Uh, Did you see I put in a request for a debug window that's just a separate window, so maybe it's a little bit easier for us to output and maintain debug info. Has he been rooting? Ooh, let me see. Oops. He's got ability available root, but I didn't see it fire. Oh, I also let him die. Are bards broken yet? They're colorful. I was about to say I thought something broke the other day with them, but no, I think there was actually something else when Nick was casting basically fearing everything in the zone. But even that, was that when the server went down, was that actually due to the fearing, or excuse me, was that a coincidence? Oh, there's a little geo bug over there. Summon another one. Let's see. Sun's coming up. It wouldn't be a stream if I didn't go over and stare at the sun. Zukin, I was asking, I think I asked you a question earlier and then distracted myself from whatever you answered. I was asking about animations, if you're rigging and taking a stab at animations at the moment, or if you're going to move to another critter. If he's listening, maybe not. I have a question for Pattis as well. So many pets. Yeah, you're gonna take a stab at rigging and animating the ones you have at the moment. Can be replaced later if we want. Get an actual anime. Okay, cool. Funny, I'm excited for the next critters now that we have these guys in. I'm gonna go look at them some more in a second. Actually fight one. Invisibility. Five. Invisibility versus elements. Just trying to remember whether or not we flagged more pets. I was trying to remember whether or not the some food and drink, that'll be good too. The elementals in the dungeon were flagged as such. Yeah, Zukin, I mean if you if you're enjoying messing with the animation, feel free. That said, I'm trying to think what we have next on the list. I mean, we've still got on the creature list, we've still got what? Some sort of crawly, right? Like a scarab beetle or other beetles. I think those will be fun. I'm very curious to see a hard shell creature like that with your style. I think that'll be really cool. And then we've got alligators. Or I guess we could do crocodiles, but crocodiles look weird. No, crocodiles, you're right. I was trying to think if... Anyway, one of those. Some sort of a... jackal dog wolf combo. I'm wondering if we can pull it off with basically one model. Maybe some little head swaps and some texture swaps. Little tweakage. No, I'm just excited. I love the critter so much, so I'm excited to see more. I'm sure everybody is. Hattis. Yeah, I think getting sort of the first stab of the new GON would be cool. And then I've been thinking a lot about the structure redo. And so it's going to be a matter of finding the right point to kind of put a pin in the stuff that we're doing with the environmental stuff, so we can switch focus on to the structures after seeing all that cool ref that you pulled together. And then thinking about, I think once we get started, I'm not trying to what's the right term, diminish the amount of effort it's going to be or whatever, but I think once we get started on this structures and starting game the new ones in, it's going to come together pretty quickly. Do you know if you guys are using the stock Unity animation system or using something like Animancer? Saw it on recent sale and wasn't quite sure what it was doing or if it's worthwhile. It has rave reviews though. Usually when things are like, why isn't this the default system in Unity, they end up being pretty good. Well, the only animations we have in it at the moment are the ones I made in Blender for like the skeleton and basically the humanoid animations. And so they were just Blender and then pulled into Unity and just set up in the usual way. Yeah, based on even the concept stuff that you whip together, Pattis, I imagine the structures will definitely be, once we get momentum on that, it's going to go pretty fast. This week, one of the things on my whiteboard is to pull together, I've got that big list of all of the things that we want to stuff in Night Harbor, then basically do a very rough sort of like top-down box map of distribution and sort of looking at the three zones and talking about, because I was hesitant before to think that we would do all three Night Harbor zones. And I'm sure they're actually, given our plans, liable to be even more, but the three main tiers for POC. But the more I think about it, this feels like, and we can talk about effort and what you're thinking in terms of, or what we run into in terms of difficulty of pulling it together. But I think it's worth considering the sort of totality of the city now and seeing if we can get jamming on that. That way we're not really just trying to jam everything down into the bottom tier, and we can really start to district things properly and get the guilds in the right places and not feel bad about putting in the extra effort to sort of blow them out and make them feel right. They don't have to be 100% done, or, you know, we don't have to go crazy with like sub themes within this theme in terms of assets and textures and all that shit. But rough layout and sort of tweaking some stuff, and even if we're going to do different textures later, you know, we were talking about color and things like that, maybe we can just do color tweaks for now, and, you know, maybe have some of the new buildings that we do, even if they're going to be replaced with slightly different geo or new geo entirely later on, then we can just kind of iterate through it. But it would kind of be cool to not have the dangling question of like the totality of the zone, if that makes sense. Because like if I go here and unmaximize scene, sorry, I saw repomp, I did it, and I failed on the other part of the instruction there, Nick. One sec, let me resummon. Elemental pet. Yeah, because I feel like it's going to be too big of a pain in the ass to try to fake the funk when it comes to jamming everything into one zone. Let's just talk about all the zones. Doug? Oh, man. I'm sorry to hear that. Good luck with the booster, dude. Definitely get rest. Vitamin D. Be sure you're getting enough vitamin D and vitamin C. I am not a doctor. I'm not giving you financial advice, but I would say that it's probably not a bad move. My wife is a dental surgeon, and we do a lot of reading about that stuff. All right, so let's get him fighting something, and then I'll do what I was about to do. Vitamin D is a big deal, though. Vitamin D. Be sure to be... Everybody should be getting vitamin D this time of year. I don't feel any guilt for telling people to get vitamin D. In Sweden? Yeah, I just wanted to get him fighting, though. In Sweden, they put vitamin D in the milk and all sorts of stuff. Lots of vitamin D supplementation in Sweden. Provoke and elemental root are on cooldown. Yep, and we just saw it fire off. Oh, hit stance on skeleton, not pet. Or, okay, we can do that as well. Hashtag fixed. Good job. But yeah, vitamin D, I'm not joking. I'm not going to give a lot of advice on a lot of shit in here, but I do think that that's one of those things. You can read about the safe levels and all of that stuff, but be sure that you're getting it. Unless you're in the sun, like, all the time still. Let me fight one of these new guys so that, we can see him a little bit. I'm still fizzling. Petak. What about the warm basking glow of your monitors? I wish it worked that way. If you could get like UV monitors, they kind of feel like it. Oh, that snake's actually pretty damn tough. I don't know why I was expecting animations. I was like, this snake isn't doing anything. I feel like ordering UV lights gets you on a list. Does that list even count anymore? In the US or whatever? I guess depending on where you're at. I've been in Europe so long, I just assumed all of America is one giant pot cloud. In Texas? Joe Rogan lives there now. I can't believe they even care about weed anymore. Hey, not. Yeah, it's funny. They look so good, they trick you. I take vitamin D supplements, so that's maybe why I don't feel anything with the COVID vaccine doses I've had. I think it's probably, it's not a bad thing. Let me summon another one. 2 weeks, I'm past my probation period, and you're fully employed. Congratulations! You just gotta keep your head down for 2 more weeks. Come here, you large rat, you. Oh, I finally got a flame burst off. First snake animation needs to be roundhouse kick. Oh, he's fast. He's dead. Saw a newsletter, haven't read it yet, but looking forward to it. Oh, it's got a lot of pictures. You should check it out. Not questioning your ability to read. Just saying. Curious to see the beetle designs. Those beetle and scare models and EQ are pretty legit. Yeah, it sucks because they're so... Man, they're so cool and really nostalgic, but we're gonna have to differentiate ourselves a bit on that. We don't need EG7 hopping in the chat. It's very arty. Not. It's interesting. I've worked with so many artists that have dyslexia. Some of my favorite folks. One of which is working with John Blakely and the crew at Mutant Arm, and I still haven't seen what they're working. I don't think they've released info. I need to check LinkedIn again and see if they've released any info on what they're working on. It's got to be an MMO. Yeah, it's interesting. I don't. Is it? I mean, I'm assuming the obvious, right? It's some sort of visual data processing differentiation. We have a tunnel. Oh, my pet's not going to like this at all. All right, you follow me. Here, we'll run over to the tunnel. We have a tunnel that leads into an indoor market area. There's some other tunnels from here. The indoor market area is built in the remnants of a giant temple complex. It's going to be fun building this out. Firehouse Beetles. And what class am I currently playing? Elementalist. Firehouse Beetles. that made me think of Firehouse sandwiches, which I haven't thought about in like 5 years. Cool to think that these new models are going to persist throughout all levels of the game, like these bats, with some tweaks, could very well be in a level 50 dungeon down the line. Same with the other newbie models, no pressure. Zukin's got ice in his veins. He feels no pressure. Firehouse subs all over here in Colorado. We had a bunch in Austin as well. I thought we had a bunch. We have at least one. I take it back. Yeah, I'm excited to get the new buildings and stuff going. As well as prop. It's gonna come together quickly. Forgot we've got auto run now. All right, I'm gonna kill some of these skeletons and see if I can get cloth gramps to drop. That was an inspired set of fizzles. Bone chip. Oh man. Oh, I think, I think I'm sleeping on it wrong, but leaning on it like that's definitely not helpful. There are a couple of topics that I had in mind that I wanted to chat with you guys about, and I'm completely spacing on them tonight. By the time I started dinner, I just realized I got the newsletter out today and got it posted on the site and all that stuff, and by the end of it, I was just like, I feel like I'm forgetting all the shit that I wanted to cover tonight, so kind of rolled in without a plan. Not said, okay, scrolled through to look at the pics at least. I'm super looking forward to this game getting a full graphics pass. It's going to be amazing to see. Thank you. And thanks for hanging out with us. So rad to see all you folks that have been here forever. Corpus says, we'll seek them out if they have Beetle Supreme subs. Mexico will be legalizing soon. Land of Liberty will be landlocked by actual liberty. They're going to be legalizing Beetle Supreme subs? Get out of here. Is it Neem 87? Feel free to give me the phonetics so I don't mess your name up. I can write you a manuscript for the next stream in case you need stuff to talk about. We'll have to see a sample of your writing first. It could be a trap. Scythe. No, I want to sell that. Okay. Bone chips, don't care about rat meat. Can go away as well. You might have to talk about cats and Mega Man. Well, if you write the script, I'll do it. It's been a while since I've owned a cat, and I always sucked at Mega Man. Alright, let me buy... Ooh, Seamurper's expensive. I can't afford it yet. Can I? Yeah, I can. I can't do math yet. Tailoring kit, though. I need to kill some more stuff. Who's that? Oh, that's Nick. I'm gonna run and grab my water real quick. I can't believe I started the stream without it. I'll be right back. Funny, Mega Man's one of those games that every once in a while, like, grab on an emulator or something. And, playing a Switch, I guess? I don't know. And I'm quickly reminded of how bad I suck at it. Old Nintendo games were hard. Kids these days, they just don't know. Yeah, Ghosts and Ghouls, the original Dark Souls. Got it on the Switch. And again, humbling. Kitos! Arkitos. Thank you for the follow. I asked the question earlier, and I may have gotten a response. No. Alright. Cool. I didn't want to blow it off if I did. Do you remember how sore your thumbs would get from the NES, like, gamepad? Did you wind up with a crazy sore thumb as well? Wasn't that a thing for a while, like, controller thumb? I'm sure some company made, like, products to help with it. I'm trying to remember the product. Oh, you the clip-on little swivel controller for the NES? Wasn't that a thing? Money. Incrementally better. Nick's just zooming around back there. Oh. So how many people actually got the newsletter today? Maybe a better question is there anybody that's not on the mailing list? I need to change my posture, guys. I think Jasmine and I accidentally switched pillows when I made the bed earlier this week. I've just been like at a weird neck strain. I tried to work it out today. And wasn't happening, so I need to sit differently tonight. Oh man, something weird's happening. I love when that, whatever that graphics issue is, whenever it happens, it gets me all excited for when we do world events. Oh, I can't wait until Ollie gets back in and adds the dust storms and the sand storms and other stuff as well. 2022 is gonna be a fun year, y'all. I am all sorts of excited. This thing's gonna come together and people are just gonna be like, deuce deuce. All of a sudden it made me think of 80s rap. Can you explain your main mechanic? So we're a very combat focused game. Our core loop is more built around the idea of like a steady grind, with combat being a bit slower paced and more focused on preparation and tactics than it is necessarily mechanical skill and reaction. Classic old tab targeted. I tell you what, before I ramble too much on something, Arkitos, Have you played old MMOs, first generation MMOs like EverQuest and Deok and the like? Nope, 22. Sorry, no worries. Have you heard of P99? Absolutely not. Interesting. P99 is for free, and that's very, like, it's the closest emulation of the old sort of level of quality of life and obfuscation and everything else that you'd be dealing with. The newer, like, I think game that's still around that still represents it would be EverQuest. They're coming up on what, their 27th expansion? The Luckland expansion is what, 27 or 28? It's been around for 22 going on 23 years. Okay, so if you haven't played any of those games, you're a younger person, I would say. It's a great question. I have to get better at sort of running through this. It's been a while. I think I've been lazy and taking the audience for granted since so many of you have played these older games. It's a combat focus game where it's very free form, more open-ended feeling. There's no indication of who's a quest giver or anything like that. It's not a quest driven game. It's very much a sort of combat-based progression game where, oh, did I just get kicked? Server's down. Where you basically, you go out and explore, you talk to NPCs in order to try to gather information, or you wind up on the wikis. Very much about setting your own goals. Combat in dungeons, whereas I would say most MMOs these days, you progress, like you crawl through dungeons, whereas everything is it's static. There's no instances, so everything's really kind of a space that provides opportunity for social friction. There's a lot of camping. I don't know if that's in the lexicon for younger people, but essentially you would work your way into a dungeon, typically with a group. It's a group focused game, and try to get to a camp where you will be spending a majority of your time killing things, having them repop, hoping to get lucky on a rare, grinding out experience, and talking to your fellow players. Our goal is to push the systems like factioning and scheduled content, so variable content depending on what's going on in a given day, or what day it is, or what the moon cycle is, or what the weather is like, or what season it is, all of that stuff. So it's very much about constantly exploring and re-exploring. Actual support classes, actual very sort of firm group dependencies. That said, pretty varied classes, with the game being one where we won't mind adding classes over time, just to keep things sort of weird and imbalanced. Will you be able to lose gear upon death? Total corpse rot versus so you will have to do corpse recovery, but I think we'll need to keep talking on the potential for actual loss, as opposed to just there being a significant cost for recovery. What do you use for networking? What is going on with my other monitor? Hold on one second, please. It keeps blinking out. And I'm wondering what that's about. So maybe one of the tech guys can speak specifically to it. Lightnet Lib, I guess. We had started with MLAPI, and we were using, back when we were on our first iteration, and using the Unity server. And then Ali rewrote the server and then has rewritten stuff again, and now we've got two more programmers working with us. They might be in chat, or they may be working their day jobs at the moment. But if you here, we'll need to update it. I don't think it's up to date. Actually, it's not linked to FAQ. Let me. Here's a likely to be out of date tech overview for you. Losing gear is such a pain, just your 2 cents. Yeah, we want the corpse recovery to matter. We don't necessarily want you to lose your gear. And when I say we, I mean, that's just me talking. That'll be one that we play with in the coming months. Arquitos, you're very welcome. There's my ally. Man, I am still fizzling. So I meant to ask earlier. Is there anybody in here that's not on the mailing list? You didn't get the last. Did you check your various filters? Spam filter, social tab.
Smiley face.
Promotions. That's right. Promotions tab. Ishiwatari, thank you for a year. Good to see you. How are you doing, Ishii? Got the newsletter this morning on Gmail. Very good, plump bratwurst. Didn't see a notification on your phone that you got it, but it was in your email for sure. Yeah, maybe you don't get a notification if it goes into promotion. That way you're not getting spammed. We absolutely try not to spam you on the mailing list. Matter of fact, I think this is probably one of the first emails I've sent to the mailing list in quite a while. If you do have corpse recovery, having it last for a week is good. Maybe if a player can't get their corpse within a week, maybe have an NPC be able to summon it back. And if a player can't find another player to help use a corpse, maybe have an NPC be able to summon it from a certain zone. Yeah, we've talked a bunch on this topic, so I think we're going to play around with some of those ideas when the time comes. It's probably going to be around first of the year when we're starting to hit some of this stuff. And we'll play around with it. I think we can do a lot to make it so that it's not like, completely hopeless and overly punishing while still retaining, that strong desire to do everything you can to go get your corpse recovered. I have to have my email open at all times for work so I don't miss it. Last email I got from MMM was June 14th about joining the new Discord server. Really? We started working on this roughly last September. That was like the very, very first sort of everybody getting together and us starting to poke at it and stuff like that. So. Just a bit over a year. We've opted to keep most things in like on the art side placeholder while we're continuing to work through the art style and gather up folks on the team to help in that area. Can I afford it? Yeah, I can. Cool. I thought it said a shitty gnome. No, a shifty gnome. Nick added a shifty gnome based on a adventure we had one night in, was it Droga? Nurga? Cryptini, are you sure that you're signed up? Alright, let me deconstruct this because I am not getting any cloth scrap drops. Cool. Eastmel Fuzzle Cutter, whatever do you mean? Bane Shock. Oh, here it comes. Ping you later. You rascal. Well, I'm getting better. That was only one fizzle. Okay, this may be a mean question, but I'm legit interested. Why should I play Eminem over P99 or EQ in general? I think if you're looking at EQ in general, it's going to be at this point a significantly different experience. If you're looking at P99, I guess the question would be, if you're extremely invested in Classic EverQuest, it may be a challenge to sort of lure you in, but what you're going to get here that you're not getting on P99 is an environment in which we're taking systems that may be familiar to you, and we're putting our own take on them. And we're taking many of those systems and adding a lot of depth, unpredictability, and you don't necessarily want that in certain systems, but in the environment, we're definitely going to be focusing on extending those systems to provide a better sense of place, a far greater sense of mystery, and discovery. So both the depth of exploration of the content and that sense of discovering new things is going to be, I think, far greater when you're playing our game. And it's going to have a very different live operations feel. So a lot of stuff will be familiar if you're interested in P99 or Classic EQ. It's going to be familiar. You're going to grok it, but definitely going to be some different takes on it. And it's going to take a lot of those systems that maybe you like. Elements of questing and factioning and exploration, and being a part of the world, and really just extend them much, much deeper. What the hell is this? Oh, cloth bracer. I was like, did I just get a big cup of milk? A glass of milk. Hell yeah. Worthless without cookies, Jasmine said. We had cookies last night. I made some cookies. It was just one of the store-bought rolls of cookies. You cut it and bake them. And we had just enough milk for coffee this morning, so I could not have a glass of milk with the cookies. Hopefully our client will feel a little less janky too. Yeah, and I think, you know, in the superficial things, they do add up, right? It's, you know, it's going to be a very pretty take on the classic style. And so as you see it come together, speaking of cooking, you need to get going. See you not. And congrats if I don't see you in 2 weeks. Congrats on becoming a full-time member of your team. A permanent member of your team. What kind of cookies? They were weird. They're like a weird synthetic sugar cookie with like a raspberry red heart. Kind of raspberry flavor sugar cookie inner part. They're a bit weird, but they're warm and they're kind of cookie like, and sometimes that's all you need. Is it being filtered? Gmail filtered promotion. Yep. Yeah, so our our email is definitely going into the promotion folder for most people. I tried to make it look a little bit cooler today. I was actually typing in, like, I was converting the color over to hex to put into, like, make it our usual website background color. And as I was typing it in, it came up green because I hadn't finished it. And it looked like an old module, like a little booklet. And so I was like, I kind of dig that green. And so I just went with it today. But I didn't want it to just be like plain white. But I also was not going to put all of the images and everything into the email. So yeah, people had to click. Last I checked, only 50% of people clicked, but hopefully it's because they know to check the website. So, email looked great. Thank you. I wonder what that little bit of hitching is today. Biting bits. Thank you for the follow. Speaking of EQP99, thoughts on EQ updating 64-bit client? Not particularly techie myself, so I'm not sure of the sort of implications that may have. I am not techie enough to fully appreciate the implications either, aside from it being modern. And I'm assuming there may be some... Wasn't there something with applications needing to be... Am I thinking Mac? What am I thinking of? I thought things had to be 64-bit for some damn reason coming up. I don't know. Yeah, so... Because I could have sworn that was a conversation at my last company. I mean... Who knows? That could be part of it. But overall, I guess my thoughts on it are, I read the update, and it's cool that they're continuing to support the game. So, I'm still sort of waiting to see if there's going to be a big announcement, from their end. Jen, in her producer update, mentioned open positions, but when I looked on the website, it looked like everything was for Austin. I didn't see any art positions, because she had mentioned art. I didn't see any art positions for California. How's Zookin doing? Zoe, yeah. Yeah, that was it then. It's because at Star Stable, like 20% of the girls that were playing our game were on Mac. And we didn't really provide very much Mac support, unfortunately. Oh, let's see. Zookin said, did the hitching start up recently again, or has it been happening the entire time? I stopped noticing it earlier tonight, but I know it's been happening all night tonight. So maybe it stopped for a little bit earlier, but... Was it brought up in Slack at all? Zookin, do you know? That's right, the pathing changes. I could see that potentially introducing something like this. Perfa Durfa. I think that's a fine desire to have, especially if you're somebody that's been raiding for a long time. If you're heavily invested in that aspect of the game, I can definitely see that desire. How's my inventory looking? It is full. Might have to adjust the drop rates on these guys. So far, I've gotten 2 pieces of cloth and no scrap. I thought that I had plugged the cloth scrap dropped into that existing cloth armor table. The way I did it may have jacked the probability a bit. So, if you don't mind, take a look at it and see if it makes sense to you. But so far tonight, I mean, random is random, right? So it doesn't necessarily mean anything. It's very anecdotal. But I think I've gotten, what, 2 or 3 pieces of cloth and not a single cloth scrap. So I just scrapped those. You got rooted, fool. Well, and he's still running. Try repop. All right. Did it look weird to you? I think I just went in and like shaved a bit off of each of the cloth and then combined all of that to make the cloth scrap. If I repop the zone, we'll take a look. Level 2. Oh, but I up my level manually. Okay. Did I lose my pet? Really? Oh, because I repopped. Duh. Big dummy. Try a different pet. And just think, there are going to be people that come to the stream starting today that have never seen the capsule bats or the capsule rats in action. They're going to think this is what the games always look like. Those poor folks, they're missing out. This is so batty, so ratty. At least get a tic-tac pet. Yeah, we'll have these guys around for a little bit still. Until Zookin makes the coolest pet ever. Thanks, Arquitos. So, I'm asking seriously now. So one of the reasons why we do, we've just been streaming this thing the whole time. Well, partially because the stream said, wouldn't it be cool if you make a game? And we said, yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. And so we went ahead with it. But just so that we get feedback in real time. as a 22-year-old that hasn't played the old, like, original MMOs, that art style, it really works for you? Honest question. I'm very curious about, like, I think the folks that, excuse me, all came from, like, the 99 era, 99-2000 era. I'm hoping they look at it and they kind of get, it's like this, yeah, sort of, the like Corbett said, it's a bit of a remaster on the art style, but very much sort of a homage to back in the day. But the younger crowd, I'm very curious to see if they're going to receive it. Not that we're dependent necessarily on making a big splash with those folks, but I do think that if people that haven't played the games before but kind of check it out and dig the style, that clicked, then that'd be really cool. I'd be very curious to see where we go from there. Younger crowd demands skinnier jeans. They can't get any skinnier. They're painted on. The jeans are literally painted on. Build it and they will come, or something like that. Also, do snakes kick? The snakes do kick. It's one of the first, I think it's like one of the first abilities that went in. Honestly, I do not represent a majority, but I feel nostalgia in the textures. But their HD, on the other hand, I love how low poly art. And the other thing that will sell to younger audience will be VFX. To be honest, the attacks look cool, and the models will look good too, because that'll be enjoyable to cast. But environment art will be also be very important. So it's going to be the same style all the way around, right? Like, it's you know, it's consistent, and we're definitely not shooting for, like, the overdone super sculpted. We have this, any discussion we have on art, like, my only feedback tends to be over and over again. It's like, do not make it shiny, and please don't have it look sculpted. I'm a fan of the blockier look. Yeah, we've got the bats in there, Dantron. Yeah, Bilbo, the animations will definitely be something that we're looking at over and over and over. Trying to get them nice and smooth and great. Consistency art style is really important, otherwise it'll look like an asset flip game and you'll get roasted on Steam and other platforms. So we probably won't be on Steam. We'll see. I still don't know if it makes sense in terms of discoverability for what we're doing. Which, for the platform fee, yeah, I think it would be fun to see if we can make it without it. First iteration of the rat was reduced in poly count by like half. Yep. It's like, make it blockier, and then can we make, like, features more exaggerated? Bazookan, you're nailing it with the critters. Having older and younger generations in the same game could flatten the divide as well. Definitely cool when that bonding style can happen. Oh, yeah. It's funny. I wasn't even considering that often. Like, that idea of the folks that are sort of part of our primary market having kids or family members and stuff that they can introduce the old style of game to via M&M. That'd be cool. But yeah, Arquitos, one of the reasons why we went with capsules and just anything that we could make ourselves, right? Like, I'm not an artist, but was able to sort of cobble a lot of this together, just so that we would avoid giving people the impression that it was like any sort of an asset flip kind of approach, or...
Less than three.
Hey, San, thank you, buddy. 10 months. Tier 2, you're a beast. Good to see you. But yeah, we just wanted it to be obvious that stuff was placeholder until we started replacing it with our own art. And then it's clearly our art. So. Jazz and Blues, thank you for the Prime. Appreciate it. No. Don't worry about it, Isan. You know how I am. I just kind of bounce around. The first time you saw the pickles, you were like, what in the holy hell is this nonsense? But they grow on you. Yeah. Clearly placeholder. What do the horses look like? Oh, we don't have a capsule horse yet. In terms of spell effects and stuff, that's another thing where we're going to try to keep it old school, have them be simpler sprites. Here, I'll show you an example of it. So something that feels a bit simpler but uses dynamic lighting, and then is progressive in terms of as you get more powerful, then you'll see an increase in that power reflected in the spell effect. But like the more modern, crazy, noisy, all sorts of wild shit going on kind of spell effects, I think other games have that covered. We want to take it back, clean it up. Having sparkles splash everywhere is really nice. But we'll definitely be playing around a lot in that area. The stuff that's in here is just stuff that we've done as sort of non-effect artists. Using like everything's one simple default sprite in Unity. So, Dream has you loading EQ in the background, right on. Have you been playing EQ the whole time, or did we just inspire you to like reinstall? Hey, Swanee. Can I have a 12-yard long weightless paddle sword that shoots lasers? I don't know that I can promise that. Nick made you a non-fungible tunic. You're going to have to live with that. Please promise the answer is no. Yeah, I was just trying to be polite. During the day, I'm such a crypto nerd that I'm so bummed that it seems like the games scene is so down on crypto. Not everybody I know, but a number of folks are up in arms But then again, maybe they're just folks that tend to be up in arms. I don't know. It's just a bummer. Because there's so much cool stuff going on there. Not for us, and definitely not in-game. But it was one of those things where I look at it, I'm like, oh. Sad face. You stopped playing in 05 or 06. Well, that's a solid 15 years. Misinformation hurdle for anything blockchain or crypto is pretty significant. Yeah. Bone chips. At first I thought it said banana chips for whatever reason. I don't know. Maybe it's Freudian. Maybe I want some banana chips and I don't realize it. Got any cloth in here I can just buy and deconstruct? No. You've slashed a decaying plantain. Druids need banana chips to cast some spells. You laugh, but I swear I'm gonna do my best to convince the team to go along with us having a shitload of reagents. Like every D&D manual ever made put together number of reagents. Or as they say, components. I just made a mistake of moving with my guild EQ2 and never went back to EQ after the guild imploded. Oh, that's bad. It's cool to hear you loading it up, though. If you haven't played in 15 years, you should definitely check out the next TLP that comes around then. Feels super worthwhile. Or you should play on P99. They still got a lot of folks that play at the low level. Get in and relive the glory days. As long as you can have a reagent pouch that holds an infinite variety of items. Maybe not infinite, but as MCP said, I think it'll be factored into storage considerations. When is the next TLP? Frank, are there people playing at the low level on Mischief? Jazz and Blues, that sounds fun. Oh yeah, I forgot. Sorry. I love leveling. Did I just one-shot him? No. Alright. It's just, I guess he lagged for a second.
Got him.
Here, let's group up. I'm gonna invite you. Cool. Hey, Bunny, are you feeling better? Lots of folks are sick right now. Group chat a thing? Should be. Party chat. Gonna feel better but tired all the time? Yeah, well, That sort of cold is definitely draining. I got to admit, though, pre-COVID, back when you could just get a cold and be super sick and not have to freak out, I used to love that once a year or whatever, when you get really sick and you like got a fever and you're bundled up and you're sweating. Man, I would have such wild, amazing dreams when I'm like feverish and sweating, the crazy fever dreams. I love it. Love it. Love that whole being bundled up and just laying in bed and freaking getting it out part of being sick. That's how the one idea you posted in Slack happened. I didn't even think about the fact here. Super sick. Initiative gets popped December 8th. Curious to see how folks like it. Protoxin plague confirmed. So, Bunny, I don't know if you're gonna be feeling up to it tomorrow or not. Oh, it may be early for you. I'm going to try to get more, if not all, but more of the timeline stuff locked down with Ham tomorrow at 4 his time, which is 2 my time, which is, what, minus 6 your time? Did I lose? Oh, he's up there. Shit. I left my ally behind. If you're awake, yeah, just if you're awake, I'll let you know when I'm on. If you're awake, cool. If not, don't sweat it. We'll get everything written up and we're using the existing timeline. It's just getting everything through the same format and answering some questions and stuff. Because the goal is to try to lock that timeline down. Timeline stuff down as quickly as possible because I want to move into the proof of concept specific regional information so that we can get rolling heavy on the details for proof of concept, because then once we get that factored in, excuse me, and match that against essentially the needs for that with regards to the mechanical needs, like class and factional stuff is all figured out in terms of locations and all of that for Night Harbor, then even before we get the Night Harbor art redone, we can start to front load the design on that and then go into front loading the data design and implementation on it. So that can get chop chopping. Do we have a stream schedule? I have to go. Yeah, so it's roughly this time. It's 8 p.m. my time in Germany, which is CEST, which is 11 a.m. Pacific time for America, Tuesdays and Thursdays. And I think it's maybe up to date when you look on, like if you look at the channel information, should be. But thanks for the questions. Oh, you're in France? Okay, yeah, so it's 8 our time. 22. And from France. And been enjoying the look of the game. I think that's fantastic. We'll be international. See you next time as well. Thanks again for stopping by. Yeah, we just need a few thousand here, a few thousand there. It'll add up. we'll be in good shape. Enchanter, okay. Twitch needs to recognize your OG and give you a purple check mark. No, that's okay. I've been thinking about multi-streaming to Facebook and YouTube at the same time. Kill like three birds with one stone. But I'd have to contact them and see if they could remove my affiliate. Cause you're not supposed to do that as an affiliate, I guess. But definitely. When I see the Fizzle message makes me smile. I had a wizard called Fizzleson. Yeah, it's Litany. I was thinking maybe just add one more day back to the schedule and do the other platforms on like an off day. Question is, do you feel that you could grow the other two communities simultaneously? I'd be curious to see what the potential uptake is. I probably wouldn't be too focused on it until I get in a better pattern of getting more content up on YouTube. Got to figure out something there. But the discoverability on YouTube is just so much better for the videos that we've posted. And Facebook, while it may seem odd, it seems like there's a lot of decent organic growth there, especially for our audience demographics, if I had to guess. So, but it would be at the moment it'd have to be a fairly low effort endeavor. Is it a little bit easier to grow here when I was streaming like five nights a week? But I don't have the energy. It's not that I don't love you. I love all of you, but shit, man. I start 8 p.m. here. It was different when neither Jasmine nor I were working last year when we were still in Stockholm before the move. It was a lot easier to stream every night because we'd hang out during the day, so we had some good time together. She'd hop on streams every once in a while. We could cook and eat together and all that stuff beforehand. All the chores were done, all the shopping was done, all that stuff. With her, back at the clinic now, like my days are a mix of M&M stuff and then all of the shopping and cooking and dog walking and I try to handle as much of the cleaning and stuff as possible. And especially with the time change and the dark weather, I am like tapped for energy. I'm old. Are we handling the server part of multiplayer? Is it client server or peer-to-peer hosted session style? It's server client. And we started with Unity server, and we were using ML API for the networking layer, and then Ollie went in and really just sort of gutted it. So that would be, I guess, a lot more efficient and easier to work with. And then since then, oh, there's a cloth piece. I'll actually put it on my hands for now. With the rest of this stuff. Then he's reworked it since then. Never been tuned in during a Jasmine stream appearance. She hasn't been on stream in forever. Yeah, it's if I'm not mistaken, it's a lot more custom now. But if you've got very specific questions, then Ali or one of our other tech folks might be able to answer them on our Discord. Sounds like Ali's had a busy couple of days, but when he's not slammed, he's pretty good about answering questions. Trying to figure out the best platform for your Appalachian Trail hike videos. For the VODs? I still think YouTube's best in terms of discoverability. But it'd be interesting to see if any of the other platforms start to take off with regards to more specific content of that sort, right? Smaller ponds, easier to be a little bit bigger fish. Would jumping be a huge lunge forward at the cost of a resource, or would we be able to jump freely? Can't say for sure, but is jump currently tied into endurance? When we do the pass, in the phase 2 milestones, I think we'll be discussing everything that may, oh, you're actually fighting. Everything that may be, oops, my bad. This guy right here, pet. Okay, I don't know what he's going after, but come back. He's saying calming down, but he's not coming back. So we'll be doing a pass, with regards to endurance and how that plays into like food and drink and various actions, and seeing if we can, the thing I'm pushing for is something that feels a little bit more, what's the right term for it? I don't want to say something that makes people freak out, but something that's puts a better it makes resources like food and drink actually matter a bit more. So custodial. In this context, I don't know. I almost said simulation-y. But I thought simulation-y or survivally would be triggering for some folks. Custodial might be good. It's just my smooth brain. Impactful is good. Yeah, so wanna make sure that when we're looking at the totality of the systems and how they're interconnected with regards to limited inventory size and weight restrictions actually mattering, and limited ability to stack certain items, and the actual utility of those items as they relate to systems, like in this case, jumping or swimming, etc. Oh, did you guys see we have a working boat out there? Yeah, there'll always be that option to use it at least a certain amount. In strafe run. There goes our ship. Have I been in Minicrypt recently? I haven't. Did you change something up in there? Alright. Zone Minicrypt. Be right back, Zookin, if you don't follow me. Our boats will work without a hitch. I'm going the way it was facing me. Hold on, I'll do it again. Minicrypt. Okay, don't go that way. Go. Wait. Damn it, I zoned again. Okay. Oh shit, you added a door. It was too dark, I didn't see what was going on. Oh shit, we got doors. I was like, is there a secret passage? Okay, this guy. Dude, he's red to me. Sorry, Zookin, run. They locked you and we have keys. Nice. Will they work? Will they work in Fallen Watch? Scale wise? I don't know what just happened there. Strafe running was faster. It wasn't an illusion. Zookin, did you die? Uh-oh. I've run into that problem before as well. All right, so while I'm walking, let me deconstruct these gloves. Oh. There's something weird with, I don't know if it's that bag or got myself kicked out a few times as well. Let me just close this out and hop back in. Again. So right clicking to open bag with item on cursor. Let me see if I can get item off cursor and then recreate that. Or, I'm not giving up these scraps. All right, so let's test this theory out. Well, first of all, let me see if I can open the bag. I can open the bag. I can put these in the bag. I can separate them out. That works normally. Pick up a rusty warhammer, right click to open bag. And it puts it down there. Interesting. But there's no issue. Oh shit. A Shiro warrior. Aggro. Oh. Maybe his pathing broke or something. He did not pursue me. Janky pathing in pretty much every dungeon. Not sure there's even a good enough spot to test that theory. It's funny. When we've talked about pathing, we've talked about maybe certain ways to simulate some of the jank. Oh, there's the Ashira. Came out of nowhere. Got him. All right, sell this. Sell the banana chips. There goes our ship. We need to set it up. Maybe I'll go add something to the dock. We need to set it up so it's easy to get onto. Oh, yellow to me. Can you walk on it though? Let's go take a look. Okay, let's try it out. Out. I guess I could just swim over there. Is there anybody in here that saw the update today and hadn't seen the stream in a while? Curious if anybody saw and was like, oh shit, they've got art starting to come online. If not, that's okay too. We do have swimming and breathing. Yeah, so honestly, if I got anywhere near attempting to try to put all of the information related to like game features and functionality and stuff in the update, it would have been too massive. So we're probably going to have another update in the not too super distant future that breaks down kind of where we're at. Maybe we'll call it like a year in review or something. Or we'll do both. So.
Yeah, there is a
ton of stuff on the tech side of things that's come online that it's just not super super obvious. Other doc? Okay. Oh, okay. Waiting on the boat. While we wait. For those of you that are maybe new here, not aware of it, if you're EQ fans, or if you just like game development discussion and history in general, check out the VODs that we have in the collections. We now have two collections because we filled one. I guess there's a limit on how many videos you can have in a collection. I think it's like, I don't know, 30 or something. So there's like 60 hours of discussions with EQ folks. And a few others, not just EQ. Any upcoming guests? Not at the moment. Nope. Nope. Oh, man. Probably hit some folks up and see if we can pull together some the panel discussions. I was thinking about that. Tracking down new folks can be kind of challenging. But maybe some of the folks that were on last year will come back. Or can hit some people up and see what the coming weeks will look like as we go into holidays. It will either be a lot easier to get some people or it may just prove impossible. Pantheon people. That'd be interesting. Jop and I talked about it last year, but it seems like they've only gotten busier and busier and busier. Matter of fact, he and I still need to catch up. It's been a few months now. Oh, yes. Guest stream with Ollie? Yes, we could do that. Team stream would be kind of cool. Have to have people kind of align, like lining it up may be difficult. We're in, what, 4 time zones? 5 time zones? So in Bahrain is 2 hours ahead of me now because of the hour time change thingy. And I'm 6 hours ahead of our closest U.S. time zone. I think that'd be fun. Group chat. So, Pattis, I don't know if you're still there, but if you are, the jaggy shapes in the background, I'd be very curious as we're redoing the mountain pieces and stuff like that, how we can kind of retain some of that shape. Man, where's the ship? I'm going to cheat and look and see where the ship is. That's me. Does it depop and repop? Or is it just out of my sphere of influence and I just don't see it? Let me look here. Zukin, you be down? Cool. Would be good. We should line it up in advance so that people know, and then everybody could come in with all their area discipline specific questions. Did you train in a shear all the way here? How did it make it so far? That's amazing. Was it one that was spawned in the city somewhere? Oh, yeah. Did you cheat your way over here? Waiting for the ship. Kid just got home from school. Crap, what time is it? Minus six. Yeah. Did you just mesmerize yourself? Are you going to miss the ship? Okay. Oh no, it just got all dark. He's like, Dad, the graphics on this game. Brad, we're not going to be Blue Capsule people forever. Don't get your hopes up, kid. Sukin immediately into the nicest area on the ship, lounging. Good job. Our ships should have an NPC that serves refreshments. Kind of afraid to screw around. If you screwed around a little bit too much on EQ ships, you'd pop through and be waiting again for 30 minutes. We should make sure there's a tavern right by where the right by the docks here, little waiting area where you can hang out with folks. Dantron said, I remember on a 56k modem zoning into over there. Ocean of Tears? Sorry. OT would be Ocean of Tears. Over there, yeah? On a ship and taking so long the boat had already left. That was always a fun 20 minutes swim. Yeah. 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 Yeah, I not only had nice. I not only had the whole like 56k problem when we moved from the skate park to just the skate shop as I was downsizing to get ready to move to California. So we just moved into like a strip mall. It was funny. It was such a classic Alabama strip mall. It was like a liquor store, lingerie store, skate shop, Bud's barber shop, and I don't know, like an insurance place on the far end. I kept having really bad connection issues. I kept getting like red packet loss constantly and called the ISP and blah blah blah. Eventually somebody from the phone company came out and said that it was because of squirrels running on the phone lines. I was so ready to get out of there. When you first started playing EQ, had the hand-me-downs from your dad, which meant zoning was on a 33k. Don't forget pawn shops. We didn't have a pawn shop in that one. I think that was the next strip mall down the street. Go down another block. Apparently there's been a lot of outages today. I don't know if you've been running into any problems on any of the things that you use. 29,000 websites down over Google issues. Huh. Yeah, I saw it on the way in. I thought Google Cloud suffering massive outages across the US, Facebook's hit. Saw it earlier on the way in and thought maybe it would affect the stream, but so far so good. Dude, taking a boat, pretty nice. Good relaxing way to see the zone. Kind of dark. You guys see okay? Will there be sharks that teleport onto the boat and kill low-level people? That would really feel nostalgic for a lot of us old EU players. Oh, I think we can probably find a way to accommodate that experience somehow. Well, we're turning, folks. Can ships be hijacked by pirate? That's a great idea. Make teleporting... You should make teleporting sharks with freaking laser beams on their heads. Yes. I can walk faster than this boat. Well, there's no wind. There's no... Does it have a sail yet? It's got a sail, but... Should make players have to buy a ticket? Yeah, I wasn't expecting anybody to be out here, Nick. Damn it. Now Nick's gonna write another bug. Ugh. Yeah, I was just thinking about the fact that oh man. Do I have a bug email waiting on me? I was just thinking about the fact that we're gonna have to, rework the terrain as well at some point. All my dunes will be reworked. Sad. Yeah, this boat's definitely creeping along. As we were going along the shore there, I wasn't sure if it was meant to feel like we were going somewhere or if we were like creeping up on somebody. Like some sort of weird pirate drive-by in a 90s movie. Menace to Shaded Dunes. Have some nice boat music. Set the lounge mood. Have like an auth mirror. Did you just attack the ship? I'm playing attack animations for some reason. The ship just killed Nick. Oh. Oh my god. Oh, ship was like... Hey, Nick. Mess around, find out. Wavebreaker. And his corpse slid off the back of it. Bye, Nick. Oh my god. He's just bobbing. Ollie was talking about if you've got heavy gear on, then you sink. Otherwise, you can float. So if you're naked, then your corpse is probably easier to recover because you're just bobbing along in the water. I'd love for rivers to have physics where they just wash your corpse further and further down the river. I'm looking forward to having river boats and ferries and you needing a ferry in order to get your pack animals and or carts, wagons, caravans over. Yeah, das Boot is not zooming. Any other EQ devs have any input on M&M? No other people on the team are allowed to have input. That is verboten. 9. Oh shit. Yep, they do. I just happen to be the one streaming, so it sounds very eye-centric. I try to say we a lot. Or am I misunderstanding your question? This is a new angle. You guys have not seen the sunrise like this before. Water needs some work, but fortunately we have somebody that's got experience working on water and boots. So it'll only get better. So imagine this. Let me set the scene. Imagine, because this is, this does not convey the scale of the city. It's a start, but... So imagine you're rolling up on a ship to Night Harbor for the first time, and you see this big ass crazy tiered city, and it's got the tiers, and you get the dome, and you're coming up here and the damn sun's coming up, and it's like, what is this giant place of adventure that I'm about to go into? Oh my god, what is this place? I'm coming from, little whatever treehouse or some shit. Maybe I'm an elf. A woody elf. And I'm coming to this epic city of mystery and adventure. I hope I don't get lost. Are you typing in the wrong area? Did you mean to type in here? You played around with putting in fancy water earlier? You are the person I was referring to, Pilgrim. Pilgrim has worked on some ship games. What happened when you tried the fancy water earlier? It looks fancy. There you go. Great success. This being a port city, we need to put more boats on the docks as prop, so it's not just the one boat sailing in and out. Fair point. I wonder if the actual water volume extends all the way out here, or if I'm gonna fall to my death if I jump off. Don't look over here. I won't look over there. Or that giant just stretch texture. Oh my god. Or whatever's going on with my skybox right now. None of this was meant to be seen yet. All right, here we go. Will levitation screw up? I almost said boot again. What the hell? Boat mechanics, like when EQ first came out. No. It might mess with the canoes, though. let me click that. Can boats punch back for 32k damage? Or, well, no, they seem to hit for an average of like, looks like maybe 70 points damage. The boat just killed Nick. Nick's knockback bug. Let me. Nick levitates himself. And knocks himself back. Rocket jump is apparently the best way to travel across the zone. You're gonna make me sick. What? It's still going. Yeah, I know. I was like, oops. Alright, well, while you're doing that, I'm gonna slowly creep. Oh no, canceled from Twitch now. Let me find the... John? Can I show it in here? Or do we want to save it as a surprise? I'm looking at it in, Yeah, okay. I don't mind. Or I can take them in a little bit. I'm cool either way. Let me pop it out here. Open a new window. That'll work. Imagine, if you will. Looking pretty watery. I'm so excited for this. Yeah, John, that first night that you were showing off, like messing with the water and stuff, is really cool to just think of the various water types and environments and stuff. This looks great. What just happened, music? Oh, it said, I'm done. Want to swim in that right now? Yeah, let's look at it again. Oh no. There we go. It's gonna look fantastic. And John, is there any sort of practical limitation on getting it in at the moment, or what sort of work would be required? Man, this fisherman's out here just murdering crocodiles. And would it be, is it going to be a different shader? Okay, yeah, I was about to say, would it be different? Because I just sort of cobbled stuff together for the water planes. Plop some stuff in and... They may be on the same plane-ish. All right. It's 10:45. I tell you what, y'all. I'm going to get ready to wrap things up here. Again, if we've got new people that have not signed up for the mailing list, I'm about to type it in here. If you'd be as kind as to sign up, that's cool. It gives us sort of a running list of who's interested, and we can also see when you unsubscribe, and maybe that lets us know that you're not interested anymore. Fortunately, not very many people have done that. Let me check the data with the mail going out today. I'm gonna look at metric. We got a lot of folks that have opened it, but still we got about 60% of the people still need to open it. So I may resend it again tomorrow. We'll see. Anyway, sign up for the mailing list if you like what you've seen in the update and or stream. Be sure to let your communities and friends and people you play with and family and all that know about us as well. Hop into our Discord. You can also hang out in the stream Discord. You're very welcome, Monkey. Good to see you again. Oh, and if you're completely new and don't know what the hell we're talking about, here's our website. We'll be updating some parts of the website this week, actually. Got some new images, replaced some of the old images, got some things to tidy up. So we'll be doing that, and yeah, I think that covers it. Thanks for showing us the water, John. Extremely cool. Looks really, really good. I'm excited. All these little pieces will continue to come together, and before you know it, those of you that have been hanging out with us for a year now, it's really, really going to start to look like a different game. So, pretty damn excited. Keep an eye out. We should be getting that player character model that you saw in the update. Hopefully we'll be getting that mesh rigged and ready to play around with in the, hopefully this week, to be honest. And then we'll see, don't want to distract Ollie and company from the stuff that they're working on now, but, in December for sure, it seems like that'll be more and more of a focus in terms of anims and other stuff. So it'll be good. All right. I'm going to wrap up. Thanks for hanging out tonight. Thanks for checking out the update. It was good to see everybody. See you on Thursday, same time. Same Desert Bat time, same Desert Bat channel. Zookin, again, your critters are looking great. Good job. They're gonna be so badass animated. All right. See you guys.